evacuation announcement. For tsunami, please make your way to Watuwanga Primary School and assemble at the school compound. In case of fire, use the exit signs and make your way to the assembly area at the car park, and wait until National Fire Authority gives the clearance. For some in-house rules, no smoking is allowed in the premises. If you wish to have a cigarette, kindly smoke outside the fenced area. For any rubbish, kindly dispose them in the wheel bins provided. Washrooms are located at the ends on the top and ground floors. Fiji Sports Council is the custodian of Vodafone Arena, and as patrons, you have a duty to ensure that you abide by these rules for your safety as well as to avoid damages. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the graduates of the School of Law and Social Sciences, Pacific Center for Environment and Sustainable Development, School of Pacific Arts, Communication and Education, and the School of Accounting, Finance and Economics. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the Chancellor's party. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated.
Let us come together as one in prayer. Let's pray. Respecting the diverse faith, religious, spiritual, and scientific traditions among all at the University of the South Pacific, woven together in the mating of life, valuing the cultural heritage and tradition of our island nations, living our relationship with the land, sea, and sky, we welcome all council members, students, staff, alumni, and friends of the university. May the collective leadership of the university inspire and guide us, formulating global ethics, educating the heart, and teaching love, compassion, and justice, mindfulness, and peace. And as you embark on your journey beyond the university, may the wellspring of your love within you be poured forth such that your hearts may sing, your works be fulfilling, serving, celebrating the Pacific and beyond with a greater sense of vision and purpose. For this we pray, Amen.
The Chancellor and Governor General of the Solomon Islands, His Excellency Sir David Okete Vuvuiri Wunangi, Cabinet Ministers and Members of Parliament, Your Excellencies, Members of the Diplomatic Corps, Members of the Judiciary, Council and Senate Members, Vice Chancellor and President, Deputy Vice Chancellor and Vice President, Chief Operating Officer, Senior Management Team, graduates, distinguished guests, families, and friends. It is my honor and pleasure to be present at this graduation ceremony for the conferment of degrees and awarding of diplomas and certificates. Graduation is a very special occasion for all our graduates and their families, and I warmly welcome you all this morning. As the Pro-Chancellor and Chair of Council's representative and Member of Council, it is my duty this morning to open the third session of the April graduation ceremony, and now I formally do so. Ladies and gentlemen, I now invite the Vice Chancellor and President, Professor Paul Aluwalia, to deliver his address.
Thank you. Thank you, Deputy Prime Minister. The representative of the Chancellor and the Minister for Education of Fiji, the Honourable Viliame Navoka. Thank you, sir, for your presence. I'm sure that all our graduates are thrilled to have you here with us on this most important day in their lives. The Acting Pro-Chancellor and Chair of Council of the University of the Pacific, Emeritus Professor Pat Walsh, Honourable Ministers and Senior Officials of the Fiji Government, Excellencies and members of the Diplomatic Corps, heads of regional and international organizations, members of Council, Senate and their committees, members of USP's senior management team, representatives of the private sector and NGOs, most importantly, graduates, your families and friends, members of staff and students, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome, Nisambula, Namaste, and a very good morning to you all. On behalf of the Council, our faculty, our distinguished alumni, our families and friends of USP, it's my great pleasure to join the Deputy Prime Minister in warmly welcoming you all gathered here today to this, the third session of the April graduations for 2024. We're here to continue our 56-year-old tradition of celebrating the significant achievements of our graduates. The April graduations, as we know, this is the last session, reflect a consistent and significant increase in the number of graduates over the years. This April graduation in totality will see 1,697 graduates receive their certificates, diplomas, and degrees. Thank you all for your presence here today to recognize and honor our students on their achievements. And what a sight to see so many people who are going to receive their degrees today. To our graduates, I'm extremely delighted to be here with you today on this important occasion. And congratulations on persevering and completing your studies. You are one of those generation of students who really were affected by COVID, and it's understandable of how that perseverance has been so important to you. But you can be justly proud of your achievements, and I see before me, as I've said, so many faces brimming with the excitement of beginning the next phase of your lives. This is indeed a magical moment for you and your family. I urge you to savor today. Make sure you take lots of photos. The hat and gown that you're wearing so proudly identifies that you're driven, you're triumphant, and that you're successful. This is indeed a remarkable milestone in your lives. What you've achieved in completing a degree is a significant accomplishment. Regardless of your chosen field of study, graduation signifies the culmination of several years of hard work on your part. Today is a celebration of your efforts and also a time for us to thank our academic and professional staff who have lectured you, tutored you, encouraged and supported you, and given you the building blocks to face the world beyond the university campus. No one accomplishes anything on their own. Appreciation must go to the family and friends, employers, colleagues, sponsors, communities, and mentors who've played an important role in the success of each of our graduates. You can all be justly proud of your efforts as well. At this juncture, I want to invite our graduates to stand up, please. I want you to face your families, your friends, and all the people who have helped you. You know, they're all sitting up there. I want you to face them. And let's thank them with a warm round of applause. Now, we'll try it again. I actually want the graduates to thank all of you for what you've done for them. So let's applaud all our families. And come on, there's nearly 600 people who are applauding. Let me hear more noise. Thank you. Please be seated. See how much your families love you. They wanted to applaud you before we could even thank them. Nothing can compare to the pride of family, to the parents and families who are here. Thank you for sending these remarkable people to us. They are nothing short of inspiring. We're gathered here today to welcome each graduate into the ranks of our alumni, and we send them forth into a world that is very much in need of both their minds, but also their hearts. And as much as our students are the heart of the university, our alumni are equally our pride and joy. Once you walk out of here today, you'll become a very proud alumni or alumnus who then become our best ambassadors in various leadership positions, not only in Fiji, in our region, but around the world. Graduates, we can all agree that your journey through university may not have been an easy one, but sheer labor, skills, and talent have brought you to this point. This journey may have included sleepless nights, long hours of research, preparing presentations, studying for exams, completing assignments while traveling, or even perhaps while you were at a family function, and you may have had to sacrifice time with family and friends to do all these things. But the mere fact that you're here today shows us that you've passed an important test in life, that of hard work, patience, perseverance, and determination. Let this serve as an important reminder to each and every one of you that anything is possible for you in the future. I'm confident that USP has nurtured you not only to achieve academic success, but has prepared you to have intellectual curiosity, professional integrity, ethical values, leadership qualities, appreciation for our differences, and a deeper respect for one another, our cultures, and of course, our faiths. With education comes responsibility. And that responsibility includes looking beyond your own success to help others and our Pacific region. Go out with a purpose-driven goal to serve others. As graduates, now equipped with new knowledge and skills, use them wisely to exploit possibilities and find solutions to make a difference in our world. Let us be the leaders we need. Let us live by the values that we cherish at USP. Let us be compassionate, charitable, kind, forgiving, loving, empathetic, and most of all, respectful. Today is not the end, but the beginning of a new chapter in your lives, which is why in many parts of the world, this ceremony is not called a graduation ceremony, but a commencement ceremony. The university's region includes a vast ocean space that covers almost 20% of the Earth's surface, our blue Pacific continent. For our Pacific region and its island countries, the ocean is central to our existence. Exercising a sense of common identity and purpose linked to the ocean has been critical for protecting and promoting the potential of our shared resources. It is this commonality of the fundamental essence of the region which provides the potential to empower through collective and combined agendas and actions. The climate crisis is something that is not just local. It is global and affects everyone on this planet. However, our island nations are the vulnerable ones that are always on the receiving end of the brunt of climate change effects. There's no doubt that climate change is the greatest existential threat to our region and its people. Ladies and gentlemen, a prosperous and resilient region will require an agile, highly productive knowledge economy led by appropriately educated and skilled people. And USP will have to play a continuing and leading role in this social and economic transformation. USP has always had to be responsive and resilient. It is also best positioned to help provide leadership in these areas. Our top 10% Times Higher Education Global Ranking, which we've achieved for 3 years in a row now, means that we continue to punch above our weight when compared to the more than 30,000 universities across the globe. But as we pursue even loftier heights internationally, we're also requiring ourselves to do things universities often find challenging. We want to see our graduates and graduates go out in the world as advocates, as innovators for our region, equipped to make a contribution and difference to the lives of our families and communities. With all the challenges come opportunities to adapt, change, and innovate. As graduates of USP, we believe that you have the tools to take up the leadership roles in these spaces. Given our institution has produced more female graduates for successive years, I'm pleased to announce that this year, 62% of those graduating are female. And we want to see more women play leading roles in such areas. That is a true testament of our future. Ladies and gentlemen, on 8th of March, we celebrated the International Women's Day and we announced a very special and important initiative. Commencing from next month, supported and financed by the Vice Chancellor's Strategic Funds, we will encourage women who are on the threshold of academic promotion to focus on their research and publications. Aligned to this year's International Women's Day theme, Invest in Women, Accelerate Progress, this initiative aims to encourage and hasten the progress of women at the university through academic ranks. Graduates, we hope that your time here has shaped the nature and raised the level of your motivation to succeed in a way that reflects the level of the ambition of the university itself and the priorities set forth by our leaders across our region. Let us not forget the visionary foundation laid down by our Pacific forebearers, and which in turn has made USP the greatest success story of regional cooperation. Here, ancient familial links honed by shared challenges and resource constraints are the catalyst for enduring regional partnerships in the enhancement and empowerment of our peoples through higher education. And I sincerely hope that you, the upcoming leaders, will continue the great legacy championing the importance of education and collective actions to our region's shared agenda and common problems. As your Vice Chancellor and President, I've always taken an inclusive, familial approach in whatever we do. So graduates, today, this big USP family is celebrating you. In conclusion, I'm reminded of a quotation from a book of wisdom called Ethics for Our Fathers. It's a meditation of great teachers and scholars. And it says, and I quote, "I have learned much from my teachers, more from my colleagues, but most from my students." Thank you for that. I look forward to celebrating all that you will do for our region and the world, and the many lives that will be made better by your good work. Congratulations once again. Manaka Vakalevu, Danyawad, thank you, and God bless you all.
Thank you, Professor Aluwalia. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now listen to the recorded message by His Excellency, Sir David Vuvuiri Vunangi, Governor General of the Solomon Islands and the Chancellor of the University of the South Pacific, as he confers the degrees and awards the diplomas and certificates of the University of the South Pacific to those who have completed the requirements laid down by the Senate. Will all those who are here to be conferred degrees and awarded diplomas and certificates please stand?
I, David Vuvuiri, Governor General of the Solomon Islands and Chancellor of the University of the South Pacific, by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Charter and Statutes, now award the diplomas and certificates of the University to those present and in absentia who have completed the requirements laid down by the Senate.
Graduates, please be seated. I now call upon Dr. Sandra Chart, the acting head of the School of Law and Social Sciences, to present those who have been conferred degrees and awarded diplomas and certificates to the Chancellor's representative and Vice Chancellor and President.
The Chancellor's representative and Vice Chancellor and President, I have the honor to present to you on behalf of the School of Law and Social Sciences the following persons who have been conferred degrees and awarded diplomas and certificates. Doctor of Philosophy in Law, thesis title, A Critical Appraisal of Consumer Protection in the Regulation of General Insurance in Fiji, Pradeep Krishan Tiwari. Doctor of Philosophy in Politics and International Affairs, thesis title, The Politics of Resource Distributions, The Case of Rural Constituency Development Fund in Solomon Islands, Tony Aruhane Hiriasia. Doctor of Philosophy in Psychology, thesis title, Exploring the Diet-Related Drivers of Obesity, Overweight, and Non-Communicable Diseases, Perceptions of Food Gatekeepers from an Urban Indigenous Community in Fiji, Shazna Menaz Baksh. Master of Arts in Development Studies, Inoke Gio Droa. Master of Arts in Diplomacy and International Affairs, Tahisha Virginia Kamea. Anit Aklesh Kumar. Master of Arts in Governance, Premila Devi. Isikeli Rokawa Mataidiwa. Tenyat Nida. Master of Laws, Charles Rokolewasika Ratakele. Postgraduate Diploma in Arts, Almaz Ashiana Ahmed. Shinal Priyeshna Devi. Shamal Shavnil Dutt. Alanieta Janelle Nagale Lewai Dei. Sakaraya Bukavesi Gioniwasa. Postgraduate Diploma in Development Studies, Andy Yalunirua Serufuama Ndakuna. Jemima Tawakilai Ndaveta. Loretta Zoe Mary Jo David. Mere Railala Ndelai. Lasaro Sanganavere Ngonerara. Seni Melia Ndruandrua Wa. Postgraduate Diploma in Diplomacy and International Affairs, Ashna Ashwarya Narayan. Lavanya Uluilakemba Tom Tavala. Postgraduate Diploma in Governance, Shamal Sharon Mani. Seriana Nakasava Tui Sambeto. Professional Diploma in Legislative Drafting, Tevita Uluimbao Dhangilamba. Janice Hiangi Manueli. Geraldine Sandy Leilani Naingulevu. Melanie Rokowati Turanga Luvu. Postgraduate Certificate in Diplomacy in International Affairs, Chone Mbiundole Tikoindolo. Epeli Wainimala. Postgraduate Certificate in Gender Studies, Semaima Dende Langi Langi. Inyasi Kalodhava Senikuta. Lanieta Tui Mambu. Bachelor of Arts, Amalia Barbara Mbala Moto Mbai. Zina Alessandra Borg. Laura Francis Cheryl Buli Sovasova. Teresa Marie Cheryl Dambeyalawa. Yukta Chand. Delphina Daniel. Agnes Aki Rodney Edwards. Vivian Fuana Ota. Wendy Gembe. Lovelyn Laurel Giva Tuke. Kayan Isaac. Vandana Jyoti. Michelle Rani Kumar. Neelam Reshma Kumar. Talitha Gail Kurimbola. Usa Salawangavuka Lepani. Ria Mala. Susan Mala. Teunang Metari. Selina Momoyalewa. Nansali Pravati. George Fungale Samate. Shaina Sudashna. Tala Masina Alakoka Tafea. Lydia Rose Tokona. Sakeyase Watson Tuni. Saini Vulawalu. Lysiana Tinai Langi Langi Whippy. Unesi Jan Y. Bachelor of Arts and Bachelor of Laws. Pravneel Vinal Chand. Veresa Denge Mother Navere. Neha Kartika Reddy. Nancy Niteshna Sharma. Jotame Temo. Waisele Vakadere. Mikaele Isoa Wangavana. Bachelor of Commerce and Bachelor of Laws, Meenal Karina Chand. Rahul Ravikesh Chand. Rachel Angelica Gutenbau. Faisal Farzan Khan. Yash Kumar. Caitlin Nam. Benazir Nikita Nisha. Alini Mother Rata Mata Tamata. Rusiate Ilivani Rale. Emalis Ayoga Tapugao. Rima Naikuru Tora Tavaingia. Bachelor of Laws, Artika Shivanjani Chand. Roshil Ritnesh Chand. Shahil Shanil Chand. Chiwanji Chand. Cholame Dangi Chang. Sweta Chetty. Yep. Eliki Raloko Dakui Tonga. Palvi Diwan. Lanieta Ngonewai. Anjani Devi Gounda. Setareki Siliasau Kalesita. Muhammad Zahid Khan. Avikash Kumar. Harmony Bhavna Kumar. Nikit Nandit Kumar. Shania Shreha Kumar. Shrina Manish Kumar. Varisha Vanshika Kumar. Kajol Karina Lakan. Mirisiana Mai Kinitia Loma Loma. Dipka Darshani Mala. Maria Emily Mataika. Dipti Mudalia. Shamal Naidu, Vashnita Ashna Naidu, Baseva Tale Naulu Matua, Pio Navara, Ashta Kaushki Prakash, Ashna Ashleen Prasad, Avisha Prasad, Avishek Avinay Prasad, Sintishna Sulakshna Prasad, Alice Andikola Puamau, Philomena Jacinta Ranuku, Eleonora Sawana Savo, Jessica Anjali Singh, Neha Nikita Singh, Chanel Vandana Singh, Mai Kelly Talatala, Hannah Gloria Tamani, Berikan Tamton, Shweta Pragati Tiwari, Sevanaya Watikini Tuiwasa, Jotivini Naivono Ului Nayao, John Victor Varasi, Winnie Veronica Yee, Diploma in Leadership, Governance and Human Rights, Peao Lonise Tasi, Lavania Vui Drichetti, Diploma in Police Management, Brown Capel, Certificate in Social and Community Work, Sorovesi Vanda Tikomai Naivalu, Certificate of Justice, Josese Michaele Tukana Buinamasi, Seru Pepeli Rocco Voli, ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating the graduates of the School of Law and Social Sciences.
Amen.
I now invite Dr. Arnav Singh, the Acting Director of the Pacific Center for Environment and Sustainable Development, to present those who have been conferred degrees and awarded diplomas and certificates to the Chancellor's representative and Vice Chancellor and President.
The Chancellor's representative and Vice Chancellor and President, I have the honor to present to you on behalf of the Pacific Center for Environment and Sustainable Development the following persons who have been conferred degrees and awarded diplomas and certificates. Postgraduate Diploma in Climate Change, Lithiana Andikolo. Eileen Anderson. Payal Piteshni Chand. Chioche Rake Fesaitu. Natalie Anaseni Kausime. Emele Wambale Verandrau Lasanga. Mario Charles Dunamel. Ricky Pana. Ratin Umama Rose. Keleti Sophia Tikutani. Postgraduate Diploma in Islands and Ocean Stewardship. William Graham Ferresi. Jashli Sonali Ram. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating the graduates of the Pacific Center for Environment and Sustainable Development.
I now invite Dr. Matthew Haywood, the acting head of the School of Pacific Arts, Communication and Education, to present those who have been conferred degrees and awarded diplomas and certificates to the Chancellor's representative and Vice Chancellor and President.
Chancellor's representative and Vice Chancellor and President, I have the honor to present to you on behalf of the School of Pacific Arts, Communication and Education the following persons who have been conferred degrees and awarded diplomas and certificates. Doctor of Philosophy in Education, thesis title, Climate Change Implications for Secondary School Agricultural Science Curriculum in Fiji, Ashish Kumar. Master of Arts in Applied Linguistics, Purnima Pushpa Din. Sandhya Kumari. Tupo Ratuva Singh. Master of Arts in Education, Fineyaso Tehulu. Master of Arts in Linguistics, Virendra Prasad. Master of Education, Nafisa Khatun Ali. Nikat Rahila Hussein. Krishnil Kushal Kumar. Rajiv Rajnil Kumar. Pritika Lata. Akrasita Lendua. Cecilia Nai Moku. Archana Priyashil Nand. Archana Devi Narayan. Pranish Pranil. Nishal Nishchal Prasad. Danesh Avikash Raman. Sanmila Wati Singh. Vishal Anand Singh. Anna Sorabi. Ratu Emosi Kete Rakoya Twimbamba Singa. Maria Lourdes Napoles Villaruel. Asena Nakambo Wanganidhakau. Postgraduate Diploma in Arts. Andy Alessi Taratoka Dhamma. Clarence Ashwin Kumar Das. Teraisi Euta. Polingi Hola. Eseta Alokiha Fata Latu. Semi Arthur Naisau. Postgraduate Diploma in Education. Taipa Peteru. Katrina Porsu. Chone Vuritayado Dhamma. Anupa Kushal. Ronita Devi Dial. Arti Swasti Devi. Janice Ranjina Devi. Riteshni Devi. Ali Johnny. Rasmin Nisha Khan. Anjita Lakshmi. Alofa Maisea. Tetawa Namakaina. Ashnal Avinand. Elika Pepeunga. Ravnil Rimal Prasad. Sheena Lata Prasad. Seraima Ratumbalabu. Anaseini Vunda Sandiri. Kia Parai Sambo. Ashna Shindu. Ashneel Singh. Tuakin Iotepa Tarawa. Meleya Taulua. Anik Serali Chopang. Tatai Tokanikai. Teniperere Toramon. Graduate Certificate in Education. Eleanor Lavon Ringamoto. Bachelor of Arts. Rosalind Nganoa Danford Bali. Cindy Silvarisha Chand. Elizabeth Grace Colivuso. Nikhil Ayush Kumar. Shamal Shavnil Kumar. Karishma Ashnita Kumari. Andrew Adilu Naidu. Brittany Louise Tanya Nawangatambu. Sepesa Tukana New Mataiwalu. Nani Sesivo. Milika Tambua. Zifira Vunikalo Leloma Vunilemba. Lakima Wangavuki. Lyric Paige Williams. Bachelor of Arts and Graduate Certificate in Education. Talitha Mbiau. Joshika Debi. Monica Devi. Anjali Kumar. Sharon Kristika Kumar. Koshal Sujata Lal. Simal Shiwani Lata. Mere Maramalevu. Lavinia Nangida. Shivanshi Sashi Narayan. Iliseva Lumaluma Natale. Shagufa Fuzmin Nisha. James Prashant Pariachi. Daksha Sharma. Salote Maria Tokesa Lili. Karaina no Takaie. Sima Sharon Vandana. Bachelor of Education, Early Childhood Education and Care, Anisha Shainaz. Joshika Devi Shankar. Kartika Poonam Kaur Singh. Bachelor of Education Primary. Setefano Hakoloa Mahe. Taketi Teasepa Erasito Tofuola. Malia Anunisia Lausi Ivakauta. Bachelor of Education Secondary, Romera Senimbua. Ripeta Tesu. Bachelor of Education, Special and Inclusive Education, Divya Dasanilata. Sutana Ofati. Miriama Ngukimalea Turanga. Bachelor of Science and Graduate Certificate in Education, Shabrina Shania Bano. Dewal Jitesh Kumar. Mohamed Mohsin Mukim. Trivashni Naidu. Sweta Shivani Prasad. Archana Ashna Reddy. Kinichochi Muriwanga Sarai Senitiri. Unaisi Volasinga Vondonaivalu. Diploma in Early Childhood Education, Anna Emily Mbulatale. Eileen Ann Herder. Diploma in Early Childhood Education and Care, Titiana Andy Kinitia. Esha Ritika Chand. Surashika Devi. Safina Tasnim Khan. Sagrika Shivangani Lata. Puja Pratika Pratap. Radhika Devi Singh. Diploma in Special and Inclusive Education, Deepika Pati Devi. Krishnil Kunal Sharma. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating the graduates of the School of Pacific Arts, Communication and Education. Thank you.
I now invite Dr. Roop Singh, the acting head of the School of Accounting, Finance and Economics, to present those who have been conferred degrees and awarded diplomas and certificates to the Chancellor's representative and Vice Chancellor and President.
The Chancellor's representative and the Vice Chancellor and President, I have the honor to present to you on behalf of the School of Accounting, Finance and Economics, the following persons who have been conferred degrees and awarded diplomas and certificates. Master of Commerce in Economics, Mubashir Salman Ali. Alicia Mala. Master of Commerce in Professional Accounting, Aarti Chan. Riteshni Devi. Kamniata Kajal. Payal Kumar. Rimal Lata. Ronita Mala. Shajlin Naz. Ashnita Nand. Avnil Prasad. Krishan Prasad. Nileshma Prasad. Rinal Ragni. Samsher Razak. Pritika Singh. Postgraduate Diploma in Commerce, Shivangni Bhavna. Tibina Yiting. Aman Deo. Arishna Kumar. Naveen Kumar. Yalin Leu Leai. Kartik Maharaj. Jessica Ben Mistry. Vinita Naidu. Brinesh Prakash. Pranisha Prakash. Raziti Raj. Shreya Raj. Leilani Sekona. Sherlene Sharma. Rodney Taraha. Ione Titake. Maria Osiramu. Lowe's Yalo. Postgraduate Diploma in Forensic Accounting and Fraud Investigation, Tulia Kurambui. Vasiti Matadingo. Anditakali Vuinduvu. Postgraduate Certificate in Forensic Fraud, Financial Fraud Investigation, Loma Vinakadalai. Bachelor of Commerce, Fazia Fariha Ali. Muzamil Ali. Shihab Ali. Krishal Aryan. Shania Banu. Faiza Begum. Ravikesh Bhan. Zaina B. Shakila Bibi. Kentarawa Boyboy. Luciana Boutu. Andy Tivuna Bulamaimbao. Litia Bulavakarua. Wema Velna Bureti. Achal Chand. Arishma Chand. Ashley Chand. Ashnal Chand. Ashrita Chand. Divashna Chand. Divya Chand. Kush Kirat Chand. Nalisha Chand. Payal Pritika Chand. Ravneel Chand. Sahil Chand. Shavik Chand. Shivia Chand. Shivantika Chand. Krishnil Chandra. Mahima Chandra. Teshna Chetty. Lawrence Chow. Akosita Golati. Deepa Darshini. Anjesh Dutt. Sharia Davui. Crystal Andrea Denner. Kunal Kavitesh Dev. Amisha Devi. Ashrita Devi. Gayatri Devi. Darshika Diveshni. Swana Eli. Tawia Eritai. Senolita Faka Osefalo. Hena Rose Fong. Laniana Ginigini. Harishna Gosai. Daniel Alec Guivalu. Alisi Halatanu. Ghazala bin Iqbal. Rakiba Shabnam Iqbal. Aryan Kalyan. Anis Khan. Aziza Khan. Muhammad Numan Khan. Shifta Nimisha Kilawan. Peniana Kikau. Telai Koro Vula Vula. Elvin Kumar. Angeline Kumar. Aniket Kumar. Anishchal Elvis Kumar. Avishek Kumar. Dheeraj Kumar. Isha Ishika Kumar. Kavit Kavitesh Kumar. Nandini Neha Kumar. Pawan Kumar. Priya Priti Kumar. Rahil Kumar. Ranisha Rashika Kumar. Shanil Kumar. Shanish Ashwin Kumar. Trisha Anjali Kumar. Vinil Kumar. Avantika Kumari. Kavish Kritesh Lal. Nifshil Lal. Amisha Lata. Tanvi Lingam. Lilieta Litia. Teresia Ofa Lodo. Akineta Bulumbo Lombo. Kajal Maharaj. Mele Muala Makasiale. Neha Mala. Suwane Malupo. Vikrant Vikash Mani. Wilson Colin Marau. Saivora Mataitini. Priyanka Mishra. Upashna Mishra. Afzal Rashid Muhammad. Avneel Kumar Mohan. And Evisake Musu.
Yes.
I now invite the Deputy Vice Chancellor and Vice President of Education, Professor Chito Bonuelelei. Are you okay? Sorry. Oh, okay, I'm sorry. Sorry.
Ashima Naz. Ritikesh Naidu. Savantika Naidu. Yashneel Naidu. April Lisa Naingulevu. Ritik Nair. Mariseni Naivoli. Maranisese Nakelo. Dorish Nand. Sita Nand. Melvin Nand. Natasha Narayan. Sneha Narayan. Shreya Nath. Esther Salatele Naua. Divya Pala. Ketril Patience. Ronak Prajapati. Roshika Prakash. Shail Prakash. Abhishek Prasad. Anitesh Prasad. Aryan Prasad. Avantika Prasad. Divyani Prasad. Kajal Prasad. Komal Prasad. Priyanshu Prasad. Ravinesh Prasad. Rishi Prasad. Rishant Prasad. Ria Renita Prasad. Shatneel Prasad. Shivinesh Prasad. Srishti Prasad. Swashna Prasad. Devanil Raj. Krishan Raj. Aditvi Ram. Avitesh Ram. Jessica Ram. Shinal Ram. Ayushi Rani. Priyanjal Rani. Leilani Rasolo. Laisa Ratu. Terai Redfern. Suhaila Safia. Krishnil Sagar. Ane Bulabalavu Saini Naivalu. Anishchal Sami. Shazia Sattar. Sivika. Olini Seru. Ahmed Shah. Krishika Shah. Shamaela Shah. Muhammad Shahid. Simran Shankar. Adirta Sharma. Priyanka Priya Sharma. Shweta Sharma. Shomita Shriti. Shamita Shyam. Bhavesh Singh. Dipshika Singh. Kavitesh Singh. Neha Singh. Nikita Singh. Ria Singh. Shamal Singh. Shivneel Singh. Whitney Siwa. Lalineta Soro Naivalu. Savinada Soravaki, Vane Soso, Fane Sovaki, Ashna Swami, Navinesh Swami, Tokin Taiti Tabore, Anifine Tale Bula Maijane, Lutia Tawati, Taine Karawa Tembuatanga, Brian Tagad, Maika Tongavutu, Diana Tolo, Meresaini Tukana, Viliame Tuni, Lenish Valsadia, Ekta Verma, Rishit Verma, Sameti Valao, Losavati Wanga Vakatonga, Michael Ewan, Bachelor of Commerce in Professional Accounting, Fazia Ali, Gabriel Are, Francisco Bhagwan, William Chen, Kaushik Chan, Manshika Chand, Nikasha Chand, Prashna Chand, Riyansha Chand, Shania Chand, Avikali Dikalolo, Belinda Ercito, Prabjit Kaur, Kartavya Kumar, Nikhil Kumar, Kenneth Lowe, Zingwei Lee, Veronica Lutelu, Sekove Matai, Meghna Narayan, Priyanshu Narayan, Shalvindra Narayan, Karalaini Naulu Matua, Nusheba Nushaba, Asnilta Prasad, Justin Prasad. Joshika Ram. Zainab Rashida. Kalera Sokilangi. Shivneel Sharma. Avantika Singh. Anushika Verma. Patrick Yalimai. Diploma in Accounting Studies, Joshmin Chand. Yashmita Kumar. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating the graduates of the School of Accounting, Finance, and Economics.
Thank you.
great singing. I jumped the gun a bit there, my apologies. I now invite the Deputy Vice Chancellor and Vice President Education, Professor Chito Vonualeilei, to present the medals and prizes recipients to the Chancellor's representative and Vice Chancellor and the President.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have the most pleasant task this morning of presenting those students who have received academic excellence in their programs and majors and are being awarded gold medals and prizes. May I invite the Chancellor and the Vice Chancellor and President to present the gold medals to the students. I also invite the respective sponsors to present the prizes to the students. Ladies and gentlemen, I am again pleased to present the following students who have achieved excellence in programs and majors in the School of Law and Social Sciences. The gold medal and the Kostiules Prize, Fiji Prize for the most outstanding graduate with a major in psychology, Nancy Parvati. The gold medal and the prize for the most outstanding graduate with a major in politics, Ozeyar Umran Akbar. The gold medal and the Kostiules Fiji Prize for the most outstanding graduate with a major in social work, Nancy Parvati. The gold medal and the prize for the Credit Corporation Fiji Limited, the most outstanding Bachelor of Arts graduate, Nancy Parvati. The gold medal and the Esco Motors Fiji All-Rounder Prize for the best female with the best combined academic performance and record of services to the community, Nancy Parvati. Ladies and gentlemen, I am again pleased to present the following students who have achieved excellence in programs from the Pacific Center for Environment and Sustainable Development. The Ito K Land Trust Board Most Outstanding Overall Results in a Postgraduate Diploma Climate Change, Jess Manikam Kumar. The gold medal and the VB Holding Prize for the most outstanding overall results in a postgraduate diploma, Jess Manikam Kumar. Ladies and gentlemen, I am again pleased to present the following students who have achieved excellence in programs and majors in the School of Pacific Arts, Communication and Education. The gold medal and the Intercontinental Hotels Group Prize for the most outstanding graduate with a major in linguistics, Lyric Paige Williams. The gold medal and prize for the most outstanding graduate with a major in geography, Senita Alapati. The storyboard award donated by David Roby and Delia and the ABC Radio Australia prize of Fiji dollars 350 to the most outstanding journalism student demonstrating the qualities and ethics in pursuit of truth and the public interest, Sarah Tikotikovata Sefeti. The gold medal and the prize for the most outstanding Master of Arts thesis, Fineaso Tehulu. Ladies and gentlemen, I am again pleased to present the following students who have achieved excellence in programs and majors in the School of Accounting, Finance and Economics. The gold medal and the Fiji Institute of Chartered Accountants Prize for the most outstanding graduate with a major in accounting, Christelle Andrea Aldena. The gold medal. The gold medal. The gold medal and the Reserve Bank of Fiji Prize for the most outstanding graduate with a major in economics, Nalisha Shavani Chand. The gold medal and the KPMG Prize for the most outstanding graduate with a major in finance, Christelle Andrea Dena. The gold medal and the Daytech Fiji PTA Limited Prize for the most outstanding graduate with a major in information systems, Priyana Radhika Mishra. The gold medal and the PricewaterhouseCoopers Prize for the most outstanding Bachelor of Commerce graduate, Christelle Andrea Dinam. The Auditor General of Fiji Award Prize, Priyana Radhika Mishra. The gold medal and the Vice Chancellor and President All-Rounder Prize for the male graduate with the best combined academic performance and Record of Services to the Community, Kavin Kavitesh Kumar. Ladies and gentlemen, please let's put our hands together for the medals and the prize recipients of the School of Law and Social Sciences, the Pacific Center for Environment and Sustainable Development, the School of Pacific Arts, Communication and Education, and the School of Accounting, Finance, and Economics. Thank you.
I now call the Vice Chancellor and President, Professor Paul Alwalia, to introduce Ms. Kaleti Tikotani, who will deliver the address on behalf of the graduates.
Ladies and gentlemen, today, Ms. Kaleti Tikotani graduated with a postgraduate diploma in climate change. She works as a team assistant at the World Bank Group and hails from Katay, Toitoya, and Lao with maternal links to Nathawa, Bua, and Wanualevu. She wishes to acknowledge her family for all their support in nurturing her own family. As the youngest of four siblings, she has raised two retired senior police officers, and hence she dedicates her achievements today to her parents who have supported her throughout the years. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Sophia, Ms. Kaleti Sophia Tikotani, to deliver the graduate address.
The Chancellor and Governor General of the Solomon Islands, His Excellency Sir David Okete Vuvuiri Vunangi, Cabinet Ministers and Members of Parliament, Your Excellencies, Members of the Diplomatic Corps, Members of the Judiciary, Council and Senate Members, Vice Chancellor and President, Deputy Vice Chancellor and Vice Presidents, Chief Operating Officer, Senior Management Team, graduates, distinguished guests, family and friends, good morning and bulivinaka to you all. Today marks a significant milestone in our lives, a day to celebrate our remarkable achievements and the culmination of years of hard work, dedication and perseverance. As we stand on the threshold of a new chapter, it is a time to reflect on the journey that has brought us here, the sacrifices made, and the triumphs achieved. To my fellow graduates, our journey has been marked by incredible resilience and unwavering commitment. We have fueled our academic pursuits with more than just coffee, energy drinks, cigarettes, bara, cream loaves, our meals of noodles and tuna, and countless cups of tea shared with our colleagues, representing the sacrifices we willingly endured to chase our dreams. Those simple meals were not just sustenance, but a universal symbol of determination and perseverance shared with friends who became family along the way. Our success is not solitary. It is the result of the collective support and guidance we received from our course coordinators, who gracefully gave us an extension to our assignment detail deadlines for reasons we came up with, some genuine and some questionable, the teaching assistants and tutors who put up with our numerous questions to understand a concept or an idea, and our peer mentors. To these stakeholders, we owe our immense gratitude. We also acknowledge and appreciate the unwavering support of our families and friends. Their never-ending prayers, encouragement, and sacrifices have been the cornerstone of our journey. They have cheered us on during moments of triumph and provided comfort during times of struggle. To our parents, siblings, spouses, children, and friends, We are forever grateful for your understanding. For times we arrived so late at night or 24 hours later because we had to pull daylight for that last minute assignment. We owe a debt of gratitude that can never truly be repaid. Today we carry their love and support in our hearts, knowing that we would not be here without them. Hence, this achievement is ours to share. Let us also take a moment to acknowledge the faithfulness of God in our journey. In moments of uncertainty and doubt, His guiding hand has been ever present, leading us through the darkest times and shining a light in the path ahead. It is only through His grace that we find the strength to persevere, and for that, God, we are eternally grateful. Amidst the challenges of nature that tested our resilience, such as the volcanic eruption in Tonga, the tropical cyclones in Vanuatu, Solomon Islands in Fiji, and other natural disasters we encountered in our own corners, we have remained steadfast in our pursuit of knowledge and growth. The Pacific region's resilience has been mirrored in our journeys, showcasing our ability to rise above adversity and emerge stronger together. Personally, my journey at USB has been filled with challenges and moments of uncertainty. There were times when I couldn't afford transportation, something that we can all relate to, and finding methods to balance life, work life, and studies led me to spend nights on campus. Those moments of struggle taught me resilience, resourcefulness, and the value of perseverance. It also allowed me to forge strong bonds with fellow students, sharing meals and dreams on the jetty at Marine Campus here at Lodhala, as we discussed our aspirations and supporting each other through thick and thin. Now, let's take a moment to celebrate the diversity of our graduating class. Each of our graduates bring a wealth of experience and hails from differing backgrounds, each of our own compelling stories. Some began their journey straight out of high school, some joined as mature students, while others sought opportunities for qualification upgrades. We have a mix of sponsored and private students. Among us are those with families and those without. However, regardless of the path taken, your presence here today speaks volumes about your unwavering commitment and dedication. As we reflect on our time here at the University of the South Pacific, we cannot overlook this institution's profound impact in shaping our lives. USP's world-class education and international focus has equipped us with the knowledge and skills to thrive in an ever-changing global landscape. Its commitment to contextualization and relevance in the Pacific region has instilled in us a deep sense of responsibilities and developed a passion for driving positive change in our communities. In the words of Ralph Waldo Emerson, and I quote, "Do not go where the path may lead. Go instead where there is no path and leave a trail," unquote. Graduates, we stand on the brink of a new adventure that is uniquely ours. Equipped with the tools, knowledge, and courage gained during our time here, we can carve new paths and create meaningful change in the world. Let us carry the spirit of community, collaboration, and innovation fostered at USP wherever we go. Remember, as Vice Chancellor once said, this graduation is not the culmination, but the commencement of a lifelong journey of learning and growth. In conclusion, I urge each of us to embrace the future with optimism and courage, remembering that success is not final and failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts. Class of 2024, congratulations on this well-deserved achievement. The world eagerly awaits our impact, and I have complete confidence in the incredible heights each of us will achieve. Thank you, Vinaka Vakalevu, and God bless.
Graduates, please stand for the singing of the Garland of Achievement. The lyrics for the Garland of Achievement can be found in the back pages of the graduation booklet.
Thank you.
Graduates, please be seated.
Before I read the valediction, I take this opportunity to thank the USP family and all the individuals who have volunteered to be part of the climax of a graduate's education journey at our regional university. We stand proud of your achievements as our Pacifica graduates. The Pacific region celebrates your achievements as we expand our capacity in human resource. You are the future of the Pacific economy. You will set the benchmark to our younger Pacific brothers and sisters. Be the role models for our Pacific children to emulate. Join the Pacific human resource to build a resilient Pacific economy so we can confidently compete in the global market of progress. Ladies and gentlemen, I now invite you to please stand for the valediction. As you graduate today from the University of the South Pacific and return to your homes, ever broaden your vision and your resolve to serve your people and humankind, and may truth, justice, and peace guide and direct you now and forever.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing as the Chancellor's party leave the hall. Ladies, gentlemen, and graduates, that concludes the ceremony. You are now invited to refreshments at the seaward side of the Vodafone Arena. Graduates, there's a 360 car booth photo shoot at the back of the arena.